Assalamualaikum, namaste, namaskar. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Sharon Zakaria. So the last couple of videos have been going really well, and we've been making some kick-ass recipes on how to make new things in a very, very simple way. So today's video is going to be very much similar, and it's going to be very special to me because I'm going to be featuring my mom in my video for the first time, and I don't know how she's going to react to it because I told her and she's all shy to face the camera. And like the title says, we're going to be making some kick-ass Kerala style, Kottayam style fish curry. I don't really know what fish we're using because my dad happened to go to the market and get some fish which he also doesn't know, so I don't know the name of the fish, bear with me for that. We're going to start with making the dish now. I'll quickly head to the kitchen and show what my mom is beginning to make. I'll see you all there. Alright guys, so we are at the kitchen right now, and this is my mom. Hi, Bara. So she's going to help me make, she's going to be making the fish curry today. The Kottayam style fish curry with coconut and all of that. You're going to be seeing what we're going to be using in a bit. So for this, we are going to be using this clay pot, this clay vessel here. This was bought from Kerala by my sister-in-law's mom. And these are the ingredients we're going to be using today. So we have some onions, we have the fish that we don't know the name of, and we have some tomatoes, some raw mangoes, some ginger, garlic, curry leaves, and some green chili. And here we have some mustard seeds, turmeric, pepper, we have some fenugreek seeds, chili powder for the spice, Kashmiri chili powder for the color because we don't use food color at home. We have some coriander powder here. And we also have some coconut paste, that's grated coconut, which has been grinded in the mixie and it's been refrigerating for a while. So this is going to be our key ingredient in the dish we're going to make today. So we're going to start off with the dish now. My mother is going to be adding some coconut oil. It's a pure Kerala dish, so you don't use normal oil. We don't know what normal oil is in Kerala, so coconut oil is the scene. And also because my mom is actually a Malayali, so she mostly cooks with coconut oil at home. Alright, so first we're going to be adding some fenugreek seeds into the oil. And you can see that there. So we add in the mustard seeds next. That's immediately after the fenugreek starts crackling a little. Now you can see that the mustard seeds is getting into play and getting into the roll there. So we're going to wait till this heats up a little and it starts crackling a little. So once that is done, we're going to add in the garlic first. And we're going to let this, you know, heat up a little, get fried in the oil a little, because the oil has to have the essence of the garlic and the ginger. That's what gives the whole curry its flavor. Next up, we have some onions going into the oil. She said she's going to cook and she's making me do all the work here. She's happily standing there and doing something. So as soon as I turn the camera on, she comes behind the camera to add in some ginger and some green chili. And I also forgot to mention that we've got some tamarind soaking in some water, and this is what is going to be giving the sour flavor to it. And fish curry is nothing. Fish curry is nothing without kodampuli, as we call it. Kodampuli. This is not the regular tamarind that you find in the shops. This is something that you get from Kerala. And this is what gives the fish its actual flavor, because Kerala style fish curry is nothing without this, guys. Trust me. So as the vegetables get cooked in the oil, my mom's adding in some tomatoes. That's one full tomato sliced. That has gone into the vessel, and one piece of raw mango. That's not a big one, that's like a medium-sized mango as far as I can see. So here it is. The best thing about this clay pot is that it gives anything that you cook, that's probably meat or fish especially, what they use in Kerala for. It gives the curry or whatever you're cooking a very peculiar taste to it, and it just enhances the taste in a better way. So my mom keeps intervening in between, saying add this, add that. So that is salt that goes into the vegetables there, and that's going to be mixed. So like I was saying, the vessel actually gives a good, you know, depth and flavor to the curry or anything that you, you know, possibly cook using the vessel. It's always good to go back into your roots and use what your ancestors have actually created back in their time, because it gives a lot of flavor to the food that we make. So as I'm talking, my mom's gonna add some turmeric. She's not even gonna waiting for me. So we've added the turmeric here. We're gonna add about 1 tablespoon of red chili for the spice.
1.5 teaspoon,
because the amount of fish that we've got is close to about 750 grams. And now we're gonna add some Kashmiri chili for the color. Like I said, we don't use food color at home, so Kashmiri chili is all that we got for the color and gives it a nice contrasting red to the curry and makes the curry look very nice. And a little bit of coriander powder, probably a tablespoon of it. You will want to keep sorting the vegetables, because at this point it does not have too much of moisture in it. My mom's adding in some curry leaves and she's gonna mix it now. It's better to keep sorting it until the raw flavor diminishes before you add in some water or the tamarind.
Low flame, good.
And it's most advised to put it on low flame and saute it, because this particular vessel tends to heat up, and you know, the bottom of the substance that you're frying actually tends to get caught up on the vessel. So now she's gonna add in some water into the vessel. It already smells good, but the chili is actually punching the back of my throat. I don't know how my mom's standing and surviving. And now you can see that the curry is taking some real good color, and it looks nice and red, just like how we would want our fish curry to be. And now she's gonna add in that kodam puli. That's the key ingredient to the fish curry. The tamarind is what gives the fish curry the beautiful sourness, and you know, it balances out that spice and the flavor so well, guys. Y'all have definitely got to try this recipe. And now she's going to add in the coconut paste that we've grinded from the mixie, and we're going to give this a mix. Check this out. You can see the colors change so well, from a dark red, like a dark bright red, to almost an orangish color because of the whiteness of the coconut. And doesn't it look good? And some more water to it. So we're gonna leave this here and let the gravy boil in and thicken a little, and we're gonna get back in a while. Now we're gonna add the fish inside one by one. You wanna be careful of the fish, because too much of fiddling around with the meat, with the fish meat, is gonna break the fish once it starts getting cooked. So you wanna, like, you know, space it out a little and add it one by one and not just dump it in, like how I've been doing in the other videos with the chicken. Fish needs to be taken care of a little extra. You need some handling with care. So instead of using the spoon to mix it, my mom's actually taking the vessel by itself and mixing it. So that's all you need. That's a pro tip. Thank you. So you need such pro tips to actually get the fish cooking and soak into that gravy. You can see the gravy boiling away to glory, and I'm quickly going to take a small bit of the piece of fish to show you all. It's cooking nice and it's changed color drastically, and it's got to have a little more to go before we add the rest of the ingredients. We're going to have to check the seasonings and add salt to taste after this. We added about 4 pieces of tamarind into the gravy initially, and we've taken it out because the gravy has reached the know, the saunas limit or the required amount of saunas that we wanted. So we've pulled it out and kept it aside, and we might add it later if we feel it is not necessary, if we feel that the saunas is not enough. But for now, it tastes really good. So we're taking a tiny bit of fenugreek powder and we're going to add it in as seasoning to the gravy. It's going to give it a really good taste, and some pepper, probably like half a teaspoon of pepper. So we're going to have the gravy ready in the next 2 minutes. I'm just going to give this a quick mix. Out of the spoon?
No.
Out of the spoon?
No, not from the spoon.
And she's adding a little bit of coconut oil.
Okay. For the
final touch of the malluness in her. And I've turned the stove off. So finally, we're going to add in some chopped coriander and two tiny bits of curry leaves to give it that curry leaf essence and taste. So any South Indian dish, especially a Kerala dish or a Tamil Nadu dish, would be entirely incomplete without curry leaves in it. So this fish curry is ready, and we're going to close this and keep it for a while. I've turned the flame off. It has to rest for a while, only then the gravy would become thick. Until then, we got to wait, because the consistency of the gravy would be too thin and we cannot eat it with anything right now. Okay, so this is my lunch for today. Some amazing Kottayam style fish curry and some plain rice to go with. The best accompaniment for this fish curry is tapioca, which in local terms you call it kappa and mean curry. So kappa means tapioca and mean curry means fish curry. So that's the two go dish at Kerala, and it tastes really good with some nice Kerala style parotta and of course the plain rice. So I'm quickly going to dig in to the fish curry and rice now. I'm going to taste I'm gonna get the entire feeling of how it tastes after so many days, because I haven't had fish in a long time and I really love fish, and we couldn't get fish because of the shutdown of all the coastal areas and the supply to Bangalore. So here it goes after a long time. I'm gonna take a nice big chunk of the fish. Man, it's hard. So I'm gonna mix it with the fish curry, take some of the curry leaves. I love curry leaves, guys. It just adds on to the flavor so much. And let's go. Oh, there's some bone. I'm gonna pull this out, throw it aside. One more bite, guys. The mandatory, the custom one more bite. The fish curry and the rice tastes so good, especially the spice in the curry is something that would leave your mouth watering, and it's already gotten me to sweat. I can't imagine to tell you how good this fish curry tastes. I hope this recipe made some sense to you all. And I hope you all tried this at home. I hope you all tried the previous recipes at home. And do try this out. Let me know in the comment box below. Do like and subscribe to my channel. Like this video, guys, because we put in a lot of effort to make such stuff for you all to watch and learn, for you all to watch and try. And I hope I see you all in another video soon. It's definitely going to be a cooking video, because you can't basically do anything else apart from this during the long lockdown. So until then, stay safe, guys. Stay armored, stay protected. I'll see you all in another video. Bye.